On the left, I've got a limescale removal acidic toilet cleaner. Hydrochloric acid, yep, being the main ingredient. And an alkaline bleach with baking soda, which really is doing nothing because the bleach is doing all of the hard lifting. I've got two toilets, both of which, as you can see, lovely, need a good clean. And I'm gonna test one on this toilet, which is gonna be the bleach. And I'm gonna test, actually, do you know what? No, I'm gonna test the limescale cleaner on this toilet, and I'm gonna test the bleach in the toilet downstairs, and I'm gonna just tell you why. Now, I'll go down to, excuse the mess, doing a spring clean. Okay, I'm gonna test the bleach on the toilet with all of the limescale to see if it does anything on it. So limescale remover upstairs, and bleach on this toilet down here. My subscribers will be very familiar with my love for pH paper. pH will indicate basically what pH anything is, so whether it's acidic or alkaline basically. So I'm gonna put our limescale remover, again acidic, into the toilet. I'm not doing any scrubbing on this just yet, but I'm gonna put the limescale remover into the toilet. I do have a tutorial on how to use this product properly, but it's fairly simple concept. So I put the limescale remover into the toilet, just running out of it now. Don't spill any on marble tile, you'll thank me later for that. And then what do I do? Yeah, I'm gonna give it a little brush to get the product just mixed in the bowl. I don't want it to, I want it to remain clinging onto this bit, so just a tiny little swirl around there. Excuse my voice, I've been sick for a week. Now, pH test. I would advocate, if you're going to stick your hands into a bowl full of acid, to wear some gloves, but they're out in the van and I couldn't be arsed. Right, okay, so pH paper. And that is immediately bringing us to, I'm gonna say, hovering in between 2 and 3. So very acidic. It's stronger than 4. It's nearly closer matching to 3. It's not quite 2, but remember, I haven't actually used very much product. You don't need to go over the top with this stuff. That indicates to me that there's enough acidity to break down and dissolve our limescale. It says that it gets to work in 5 seconds, but I'd probably give it about 15 minutes. Let's go ahead with our bleach. And roughly the same amount. Again, no need to go over the top. People use far more of these products than they really need to. I can feel that there's resistance in the limescale. So what's actually taking this off is the mechanical action of me scrubbing, but I can feel that there's resistance in the limescale. Just be careful when you're pushing this and then pulling it back up in a bowl, because those bristles can catch and flick bleach up at you. So I always recommend doing it this way when you're doing anything with either acids or alkalines. Let's pH test this and see what reading we're getting. Again, gloves, but I'm not imagining you guys are going to be sticking your hands into your toilet bowls to test the pH of toilet bowl cleaner. And we're coming in at 11, so pH 11. Let's leave this for, again, about 15 minutes, give it a scrub, and then see what we're left with. 15 minutes later, let's see what we've got. Toilet looks clean. I can still feel a little bit of resistance down there where the water is really limey and pooling down the bottom, but toilet, unsurprisingly, looks clean. Let's give it a flush. Of course we've got bubbles. Just can't actually see. All right, I'll give this a few flushes. Bubbles are nearly gone. Give it one more flush. I probably need to bring you guys in to see this, but there is still some limescale down the very, very bottom just in here. You see that? So the bleach hasn't had any effect on the heavily pooled or layered limescale down the bottom of the bowl. So I still need to put some acid in there. More on that later. But let's go upstairs and see how the other toilet is looking. Right, so in the interests of fairness, I'm gonna give this toilet a little bit of a scrub. And actually, See the little bit of lime scale just around under the waterline there? That should just, yep, just a little bit of agitation is scrubbing that off. Let's give this a flush. So you can see just along the edges there where the brush didn't get, this should be loose and just come straight off. Yeah, you can see the little bits of limescale now floating in the water, and this stuff, I need to flush this again just to get rid of this. Yeah, most of this is off, just a little bit down in there, but there is no limescale pooled in the bottom of the bowl the way there was downstairs, and that's with the acidic toilet bowl cleaner. So I'm gonna basically, we usually clean these toilets with the acidic bowl cleaner rather than the bleach for this very reason, because you end up needing to do it twice. Do not mix acid and bleach because you will create a toxic gas and you can quite literally kill yourself with it. So don't do that. My preferred method for doing this actually is using vinegar, and this video here will show you how to do just that.